So as the Marines get after a new kind of fight in the littorals, they have to make some technology upgrades to make that happen. One of them has been around for a while, but is getting some changes, and that's networking on the move. Essentially, being able to move and transmit data or download and upload data to a cloud. In the past, you'd have to stop, make yourself vulnerable, stop forward progress on any kind of mission set or patrol. But now, they can move through obstacles, do their mission set, vehicle on the ground or vehicle in the air, and still do that data transfer that they need to do. The original technology fielded in about 2013 with the Marine Corps, but now they're adapting to new systems, putting it on the MV-22 Osprey, for example, on the KC-130J, and also on ground vehicle and amphibious vehicles, such as the amphibious combat vehicle and the soon-to-be advanced reconnaissance vehicle, which is still under development. For example, back in August, Marines with 3rd Marine Regiment in Hawaii did testing with the networking on the move on the MV-22 Osprey. It was the first time those Marines had used that system in that platform. So although it's been around in some formats, such as ground vehicles, implementation in the air side and other assets is a new development for the Marine Corps. Another technology upgrade is a newer system that's getting a different kind of look in how it's being used. And that's the MADIS and LMADIS, the Marine Air Defense Integrated System. The LMADIS is a lighter version of that same system. So the LMADIS was mounted on Polaris Razor all-terrain vehicles and used in CENTCOM just a couple years ago, specifically in Syria, kind of filling gaps with air defense detection and intercepts. What they're doing now is trying to improve the intercept, or basically the missile, thing that's going to strike any target, be it a drone of a hobby-sized drone or a larger-scale drone at a higher altitude, for that LMADIS and the MADIS system. And so the new intercept they want is to take out, in a cheaper way, in a quicker way, small hobby-style drones, things used often by terrorists or other types of groups, to thwart different types of radar systems and present a new threat to Marine units and Army units out in the field. So the Marines want a cheaper and ready-to-go, prototyped and operationally tested interceptor for that system that's been around about 3 to 5 years. They've asked for that very recently. They want some things delivered to them just in the next few months. So we'll see kind of where they get after that, because it's a lot cheaper to send a smaller type of intercept to a smaller type of drone than it would be to send a big honking missile after every little thing that crosses your path. So both of these pieces of technology basically are trying to make Marines' lives easier, especially in conditions where they don't have a lot of support. So networking on the move allows them to get data to upgrade and update their maps, update and upgrade the reconnaissance and intelligence that's been provided to them, and also provide that to higher command. You know, the MADIS and LMADIS are small unit air defense. You know, the Marines and the Army really got out of the air defense game for a couple decades because there really wasn't much of an air defense threat in coin operations and counterterrorism operations in Afghanistan and Iraq. Now that changed over time with small commercial drones, but it's increased quite a bit with the great power competition that the US is entering with Iran, China, Russia, North Korea. All those countries have pretty sophisticated air attack abilities, and if we're anywhere near their borders, we're going to have to face that. And obviously the Marines are going to be prepared for that if they have the right kind of equipment, technology, and training.